Astable multivibrator using 555 timer. We know that multivibrator can be categorized mainly into three heads. So head number one is your Astable multivibrator, we are going to discuss here. And next one is our bistable multivibrator. And the last one is our monostable multivibrator. All the flip-flops are the good examples of bistable multivibrator. And in case of monostable, the output of the circuit will remain stable either at the low level or at the high level. When you shall give some trigger to the circuit, then it will switch to the other level and it will be there for a certain period of time, then it will come back to the original initial level. So that was our monostable multivibrator. In case of astable multivibrator, the output of the circuit will be oscillating in between the high voltage and the low voltage. So here is the respective 555 timer in the astable multivibrator mode. So 555 timer is nothing but one 8-pin deep IC which is having mainly four components. So component number one is that it is having two comparators. So it is having plus terminal, minus terminal. So when the positive terminal voltage will be greater than the negative terminal voltage, output will be high. And otherwise, when the positive terminal voltage will be lesser than this negative terminal voltage, then the output will be low. So it is having two comparators. It is having one SR latch. It is having one discharging transistor. And it is having relaxation oscillator. Question is coming in mind, then what is the relaxation oscillator? Relaxation oscillator means that very oscillator whose oscillation frequency will depend upon the condenser's charging discharging time. So here is the condenser whose charging discharging time will decide the oscillation frequency of this astable multivibrator. We know that in case of astable multivibrator, this condenser is getting charged through this VCC, through this current, charging current is coming through RA and RB. So RA plus RB, because they are connected in series to make the charging current pass through this condenser. But when the condenser will get discharged through this discharging transistor, then on the path it will be having only RB. So we know the basic principle of this astable multivibrator using 555 timer. So now here, this is the charging time and this is the discharging time. You see the charging time, the length, that is the time period, that is the time cycle required for charging will be larger than the time cycle required for the discharging, because the charging current will be coming through RA plus RB and the discharging current will be passing through only RB. So that's why charging time will be higher than the discharging time. So this is the respective charging discharging graph for the condenser. And accordingly, we are going to get the respective output from here. So this is the Q bar. So from here, we are getting the respective output. We know that this condenser will be charged when the transistor is off. Off means at the base, it will be getting 0 volt. So 0 means the Q bar will be getting high. So when the condenser is charging, the output should be high. When the condenser is discharging, that means the output will be low. Means Q will be getting high, so that will make this transistor on, so the condenser can get discharged through this discharging transistor through this RB. So similarly, when it is charging, I'm getting the output high. When it is discharging, I'm getting the output low accordingly. So here we have made the respective pin level diagram. So here we have given the pin numbers. So 8-pin deep IC. So we are giving the pin numbers and this is the respective other circuit components. So there is a schematic diagram of the 555 astable multivibrator. So if we make the circuit, if we build the circuit on our breadboard, so it will be looking like this. So here we are giving a power supply through this battery, the DC power I am giving through this battery. And here the components are getting connected according to the circuit, whatever we have shown. And there is the 555 timer, there is a pin level diagram we are having. So it is having ground, trigger, output, reset. So pin number 1, 2, 3, 4. And then control voltage, threshold, discharge and power supply. So they are nothing but 5, 6, 7, 8 pin numbers. So this is the same circuit, whatever we have shown you earlier. We have drawn the same circuit in our PSPICE software. So in the PSPICE software, we have drawn the same circuit. And what are the parts we required? we require parts that is 555D. This is the required part name. So we are having resistance, so R. We are having condenser, so C. We are having the voltage DC, so VDC. We are having the ground earth. So these are the respective part I require to design this circuit on the PSpice software. And in the analysis setup, we have made this print setup as 0.1 second and the final time will be the 6 seconds. So I can see the 6 complete cycles accordingly. So this is the respective, you know, this is the graph which we have shown earlier. So this is the graph that is the charging and discharging time being shown using the green color line. And this is the red color line which is showing the respective output. So here you can find that it is oscillating. So this is my 0 volt. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is my 6 volt you are getting. You are finding this one 6 volt. 7, 8. So it is almost coming to this. So it is nothing but that is my VCC by 3 and it is nothing but 2 VCC by 3. So the discharging graph, charging discharging graph of the condenser is oscillating in between VCC by 3 to 2 VCC by 3. So here we have given the all the respective formula whatever we require for the calculation. That is the time high, that is the time for which the output will remain high, and it is nothing but 0.693 into R1 plus R2 into C1. That is the time low, so this is a respective expression, that is 0.693 into R2 into C1. So if you get the total time period, then it is time high plus time low, so this is a respective expression for that. And there is a frequency expression, and that is a duty cycle we have calculated. Duty cycle means in the total time period, how much time, how much percentage of time the output is high. So that will decide the duty cycle here. So here in this particular simulation output of the circuit on the PSpice software, here we have done the respective calculations. We can do the calculations putting the R, C, RA, RB and C values there in the respective expressions. And also from the graph, we can find out the respective time period and they have got matched, that how far they are actually matching with the theoretical values and all. And all these things, so here we are getting this one as 1.450 second and here we are getting this one as 1.3929 second from the graph. So in this way, we are getting the respective comparative study between the practical value obtained from this graph and the theoretical value, whatever you are obtaining from the putting the corresponding component values in the respective expressions. So I think it is better, let us go for the demonstration, because practical demonstration can clear our all doubts, I can make our conception clear. So let us go for the practical demonstration right now. There, using PSpice software, I shall show you that how to construct such circuit and how to test a circuit in the simulation mode. So here is the practical demonstration for you. Here we are going to design a stable multi-vibrator circuit using 555 timer. So here we will be requiring 555 timer IC, resistances will be required, condensers will be required, we require the voltage DC, that is the VDC, and also the ground earth. So let me go for the construction of the circuit now. So here the main component is our 555 timer. So let me go for the parts searching. So it will be 555D is the respective part name. So now let me go for the other components.
we are putting voltage level marker here. So one marker we are putting to see the output, obviously, and another marker with this condenser output to show that how the charging and discharging is taking place and how the output is varying along with the charging and discharging. So we have completed our circuit almost. So what about the values, labels we had in our presentation circuit? So the same circuit I have drawn here for the better understanding of yours. So let me do one check. So it will be up to 100k, it will be 0.1, that will be 0.01 rather, I should say that we kept this one as 0.01 microfarad. So we're having this 10 microfarad, this one, and rest part I think we have done the correct. Okay, now let me go for the simulation. So here the parameter setting I'm doing for the transient. So I'm making this one as 0.1 second say, and this one I'm plotting as 6 second. I required it for the 6 second duration in total. So now going for close and then going for the simulation. So you see, this is a very fantastic curve we have obtained, and you see this this particular voltage is our 1, 2, 3, and it is our 6. So 2 to 6 volt it is varying. Why it is 2 to 6 volt? It is 0, 1, 2, 3, yes, 3 to 6 volt it is varying. Why? Because I gave this voltage that is was of 9 volt, I think. So 9 volt was there. So 1 by 3 will be 1 by 3 of 9 volt, means 3 volt, and 2 by 3, so that will be of 6 volt. So that's why this charging and discharging of this condenser is varying in between 1 by 3 times of the input voltage and 2 by 3 times of the input voltage. So that's why it is varying from 3 volt to 6 volt. In this way, we are getting the explanation accordingly. You can also see the circuit, you see, this is the 9 volt we provided. So that's why this particular condenser charging discharging time will be ranging from 1 by 3 V1 to 2 by 3 V1. So that's why it is ranging from 3 volt to 6 volt. And from the simulation output, we are getting this, that when the condenser is getting charged, then we are having high voltage as the output. When the condenser is getting discharged, we are having this low voltage as output. So according to the planning, according to the circuit and explanation, whatever we did earlier, we are getting our respective outputs accordingly. So I think now it is very simple. We can also do the measurement. We can also do the measurement, that is a time period. We can calculate the time period. So in that case, I should use this tool. So here this value is, if you put this here, the value of this one is my 1.8155. So 1.8155, that is my this line. So if I merge with this, so that is my 1.8204. And if you go for the same phase, it is about 3.2282. So having the difference, you can easily calculate the respective time period, and from the time period also you can get the frequency and so on. So it should be checked with the theoretical value, which you can calculate using the formula, say 0.639 into within bracket R1 plus 2 star R2 bracket closed into C1. So using that formula, I'm getting the respective value, and from here also I'm getting the respective value, so we can tally them accordingly. So in this way, we can have this simulated output of this 555 timer Astable multivibrator. So multivibrator circuit using 555 timer and the respective simulation output we have shown here. And if you are having any kind of doubts, difficulties, please share them and we shall do that needful communication with you. Thanks for watching this video.